Coming to you from the second floor of the Norris University Center, this is the Daily Northwestern Basketball Roundtable with Wins beat writer Robbie Levin and myself, Danny Daly. Let's jump right into this past week. The women dropped a close one on Thursday against Michigan State, bounced back with an impressive win on the road against Wisconsin. What did you see from them this week?
Well, starting with Michigan State, it was kind of the same old story that they had fallen into their past couple of games. They had against Iowa, they were winning in the second half, and then they lost, and then against Michigan State, it was the same story. They played Michigan State very close up until the final minutes, but they just couldn't get that last knockout punch, and Michigan State kind of got back in the game, got some momentum, and it was kind of too late for Northwestern. But they rebounded nicely at Wisconsin. Like we were saying, I think, a couple weeks ago, Northwestern was bound to win a game sooner or later, and it came yesterday at Wisconsin. They just broke out in the second half. They had 41 points in the second half, shot very well. Kendall Hackney had 6 rebounds and I think 14 points, and it was an all-around team effort, and they really bounced back from 3 pretty tough losses.
Right, and in that Wisconsin game, they had been down 26-12, and then over that next 15 minutes or whatever it was, they outscored Wisconsin 45-16. That's about... That has to be as well as they've played under Joe McEwen yet. I think they'd have to be encouraged by that result, because for, you know, about 15 minutes there, they were playing some real basketball. And then that Michigan State game, I was kind of impressed with, you alluded to the rebounding, the fact that Michigan State really isn't a great matchup for them. That's a good rebounded team, and they really seemed to hang in there for a while. They would have liked to take that game away, you know, have some more momentum going here, build a little bit of a winning streak. But, I mean, it's hard to believe that Alyssa DeHaan is going to shoot like that all the time against them in terms of the jumper she was making, the 12, 13, 14 footers. But this week, all they've got is a Thursday game at home against Michigan, who they beat on the road earlier this year. What do you expect in that game?
I think either way it's going to be close. The last game they played that wasn't really close in the second half, maybe Penn State. Couple weeks ago, I don't know. Every game they play is close. So this one will be close. I think they can pull it out. What's key is that they get production from people other than Amy Jeschke, which is what they got in the second half against Wisconsin. Kendall Hackney had 14 points. Brittany Orban was in double figures. So if they can do that again against Michigan, they can beat them. So I think they can carry the momentum over and they can beat Michigan. What about you?
Yeah, I'd agree. And it'd be a big step for that team to beat a team twice in the same year, to be able to build on that from beating them on the road earlier this year and become, I don't know if consistent's the right word, but become a team that they take care of the games that they're capable of taking care of. So after that, they're going to have a week off before they go on the road to Illinois. But these next couple games here are going to be big for them as far as bolstering maybe their resume for the WNIT or something like that.
Yep, and women's basketball isn't the only basketball team in Northwestern with a big week ahead of them. The men's basketball team, after losing 2 tough road games at Minnesota and at Michigan State, returns to Evanston. They'll take on Michigan on Tuesday, and then they'll go up against Indiana on Sunday. So first, what do you see from the team last week?
That first of all, starting with that Minnesota game, that I said at the time, that might be the game that, if it's obviously early to be thinking about this, but that might be the game that if they miss the NCAA tournament, that's the game that might do it for them. If they're really close on the bubble and they miss out, not having that road win against the bubble team might end up coming back to haunt them. And they had chances to win that game. They were ahead late in the second half, kind of like the women's team's been going through, and then Minnesota get hot from beyond the arc, and that kind of killed him. John Scherner had been playing well, and then I think those last 2 three-pointers were over his outstretched hand. And then at Michigan State, it was kind of similar to that game that was played here, in that they stuck with him for a half. They stuck with him even, you know, for the whole half this time, rather than about 16, 17 minutes. And then there was that 8-minute stretch at the beginning of the second half where Michigan State just pulled away. And in fact, Michigan State was leading at the half mainly because of their offensive rebounding. Luka Mirkovic's foul trouble played into that. So now this week is huge for them, and that they've got 2 games that they really can't afford to lose. Obviously, there's still time left if they were to win at Wisconsin or something like that. But they're at the stage of the season now where, you know, they've got to be, every game is really important for them in terms of building their resume. And going up against Michigan, who, like the women's team, they beat on the road earlier this year, and then Indiana, the bottom half of the conference, those are going to be two big games for them.
Yeah, and I think looking back at Minnesota, it's just too bad that the best three-point shooter in the conference got hot at the right time for the Gophers. Blake Hofhauer hit a bunch of threes there at the end, and you know there's nothing Northwestern could do. And then the Michigan State game, not many people expect Northwestern to win, but Michigan State is clearly the best team in the conference, and they proved it. And so I think that's a tough loss, but Northwestern certainly does have the opportunity, and they need to bounce back, because I think almost every game now is a must-win game.
Yeah, and that was really Northwestern's second-to-last shot at a really marquee win. Yeah. They're going to go to Wisconsin a couple weeks down the line, but between that game and this past game against Michigan State, that was a chance to build on that Purdue win and kind of give them another signature win to bolster their chances.
Yeah. All right, so quickly, quick picks. What are you thinking about these two games this week?
I think they're gonna win both of them. I think the game against Michigan is gonna be fairly close. That they'll pull away. That Northwestern will pull away at the end, and then I think the Indiana game. I think they'll win that game handily. I know Indiana's been playing better, but I think Northwestern's gonna get some momentum from that Michigan game. They're gonna be back on the right track, and they'll their chances will live for another week anyway.
Yeah.
And that wraps it up for the Daily Northwestern basketball roundtable. Check us out online at dailynorthwestern.com/sports for more information.